got the President of the United States as well as the First Lady. Please welcome the First Lady of the United States and the President, the 45th President of the United States, the Trumps. Hi, Melania.
Hello, Davey.
Hi, Mr. President Trump. Hi, President Trump.
Hi, can you hear me?
Yes, yes.
Can you hear me? We're at Mar-a-Lago, David.
Oh.
We're at Mar-a-Lago. Should I tell them to turn it down?
No. Is Rudy dancing in his blue velvet tuxedo?
Rudy fell asleep, but the rest of us are going strong.
What a...
Okay, guys, listen. Everybody, turn down the music. Turn down the music. I just need 20 minutes. I promise you can pick up the dancing in 20 minutes, okay?
Thank you.
Everyone, remember your places in the conga line. I just have to talk to a Jew. Good one, okay? Just keep not masking. Keep rubbing up against each other. Just remember the conga line order. I'll be back. Here we are.
How do you arrange the conga line, Mr. President? Aren't you in charge of lining them up? How do you do
that? David, I delegate that to Pompeo. Mm-hmm. He thinks he's running the country. You know, it keeps him happy.
Well, we are honored to have you, Aaron. Thank you for taking time from your busy schedule. And not only that, you brought along your magnificent wife.
Melania.
Now I show you my teeth.
No. Soon.
She's great. She really is. She looks great.
First interview, then conga line, then spread virus, then teeth. That's leadership, David. That's leadership.
So what?
Listen, isn't she terrific? Isn't she terrific?
Yes.
Skin on her ass as smooth as a baby's ass. If that baby's ass with Jared Kushner.
Jared Kushner. So you must be so proud. And I have to say, Mr. President, for somebody who was fighting for the Oval Office just 5 minutes ago, you seem pretty happy for a guy who's in a little, you know, not winning.
Actually,
right now,
David, I do have some very good news.
Really?
Yes. Presidency Schmesidency. Melania and I just signed a big production deal with Netflix.
This is the biggest deal.
You know, Obama and Michelle.
Yeah.
Their production company, that was only $100 million. And Prince Harry and the black, what's her name? The Duchess of Compton. The Countess of Crown Heights, whatever she's from,
yeah,
the black, they signed a deal with Netflix, but right, our deal is bigger than those four losers combined, and then some. And you know why, David?
Why is that?
Ask me why our deal is so big. Go ahead, ask me.
Why is your deal?
Go ahead and ask me,
Mr. President. Why is your deal so much bigger?
Because Rosie's fat. No, that's not why. Because not only are we producing,
yes,
David, but Melania and I are also starring in the movies.
Really?
You're not going to see Barack and Michelle starring in their movies because, you know why? Because they're cowards. They're cowards. It's really shameful, David. It's a shame. It's really sad.
Well, let me get this straight. You're going to be an actor.
Excuse me, you're going to be an actor? David, yeah. I don't want to embarrass you in front of your fans. Far be it from me to ruffle any feathers or whatever it is you're trying to pass off as hair nowadays on the top of your head.
I don't think we need to be talking right now about
sad. Those plugs are so sad. Folks, really, David, you look like Sleepy Joe. Did your hair transplants? Get it? You thought I was going to say you look like Sleepy Joe, but instead I said you look like your hair plugs look like they were done by Sleepy Joe.
Right.
Sleepy Joe. And Kama Lama 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 Chameleon. She comes and goes, David. She comes and goes just like her lies.
Oh, okay.
They come in her affairs.
Mm. All right,
hey, Willie that... Brown, are you coming? Well, I'm going.
That's, we don't need to be this mean.
And Dr. Jill, how about that? Four years. Dr. Jill Biden, the doctor. The doctor will see us now. Can't wait for that.
So you were saying you're an actor, President Trump?
Yes, David. I'm what they call in the business you used to be in, a triple threat. I'm an actor, I'm a producer, and I'm a threat.
Well, being a threat, that seems to be the way things work in Hollywood these days.
You know, David, you're also a man who wears many hats.
Thank you for noticing, Mr. President, because I write on my...
You wear a lot of hats because your hair plugs are a disaster. They're a disaster.
I don't.
That was the joke.
Yeah.
We're just joking. I mean, it's entirely true, but we're joking.
I'm honored you're here. But so you're acting, you say.
Yes. You know, a lot of people love my acting. They love me. They love my acting. I'm a terrific actor.
Yeah.
You might remember my incredible performance in Home Alone 2.
Yes.
Hey,
yes.
McCauley, down the hall and to the left. Down the hall and to the left. Off-quoted. That's what everyone talks about.
Yeah,
that's everyone's favorite line.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I never had an acting lesson.
Really?
No, it just comes to me. Just comes to me. I don't know. I have a knack. You know, David, I had an uncle who acted.
Really?
Yeah. Lionel Trumpy Moore. Lionel Trumpy Moore. I guess I got it. I guess I got it from him. I don't know.
Lionel Trumpy Moore.
Down the hall and to the left. Speaks for itself. Honestly, I had to dial that line back, David. You know,
really?
They wanted to make me after I in
rehearsal. In Home Alone 2.
In rehearsal. Christopher Columbus, who, by the way, great guy. I don't know why people are so down on him.
The director.
Taking his holiday away. Great guy. They want it.
I didn't know Christopher Columbus, the director, was Italian.
Of course, David. You know, and the slaves that worked on that movie were treated very well.
That, I did hear that.
Listen, you know, they wanted to make, after I read that line, down the hall into the left. They wanted to make me the star. They did. But I didn't think it was fair to the kid with the lips, Macaulay.
Yeah.
But I'm an incredible actor, and so is Melania. Melania's tremendous. Have you ever seen one of her movies, any of them?
Oh, of course.
They're part of the Criterion Collection.
Why, look, it's Melania Trump, the First Lady of the United States.
Hello, everybody.
I was just telling them that you're... Your movies are part of the Criterion Collection, Melania.
That's right, Tornel. My movies are on the Cry on My Teeth collection.
Well, yeah.
Many of my great films, like One Splooched Over the Cuckoo's Chest.
Okay, all right. You know, she's joking. She's,
yeah, of course.
She's joking. That's,
it's New Year's. You're still celebrating. Movie. She's conga lining.
It's anything, you know, she can't wait to get back to David Johansen. You know, hot. Yes.
Yeah.
No, David's talking. He's making a speech right now. Anyway. Okay.
So you're the president. Let me.
Already begun production on some of these movies for Netflix, David.
All right, so I'm a little confused. You have a production deal with Netflix, but you're still the president of the United States, and yet you found time in your schedule to make movies for Netflix?
Well, yes, you know, I had to cut my golf down to 3 times a week.
Oh, that's...
But it worked out. But it worked out, and I'll tell you why. After I defunded the CDC's pandemic response team in April, there was plenty of office space right across the hall from our studio.
No.
Did you know they gave, David, did you know this? That they gave those phony science losers a whole floor.
A whole floor.
Swamp. Drained it. Bye-bye, swamp.
Thank you for doing that. So you have this deal with Netflix?
May we show you the dailies? I'm very excited about this. I just saw the dailies last night. Would you be so kind as to allow us to show you
the
dailies?
Yes. Yes. Thank you.
You're very kind.
Yes.
You're very kind.
Well, this is exciting. So we're the first ones to see these movies that Melania, First Lady Melania, and President Trump are making. What's the first movie we're going to see?
Well, Davey, the first big movie is a Big Lee Productions remake of Philadelphia, which had so much potential, but the original producers made the amateur mistake of giving the starring roles to a well-known child molester, a baby blood connoisseur, Tom Hanks.
Oh, right, yeah.
And Denzel Roosevelt, or Jefferson, or whatever the sheet slave owning president he was named after.
Yeah, Melania, Denzel Washington. Washington, who, by the way, horrible actor.
Really?
So overrated. Anyone, a child could act circles around him. Certainly I could.
Really?
I turned down Training Day. You know that.
Why would you have turned down Training Day?
Because, David, I'm a professional. They couldn't get everyone to sign an NDA, David. You think I'm going to spend 3 weeks shooting in South Central and have to worry about something slipping out of my mouth and getting splashed all over the internet? Okay. That's not how I work.
It isn't. So tell me about your remake of Philadelphia for Netflix. What can we expect?
Okay, Davey. Here's a scene from
Philadelphia.
Philadelphia.
Right.
That is what I said.
Right.
Where Tonnell plays a man fired from his job because he has been falsely accused of having AIDS virus. And he comes on me seeking legal double repenetration in all three halls.
It's terrific. But first I changed the theme song, David.
The theme song
from Philadelphia.
Oh, that's a beautiful song.
Springsteen wrote. It's horrible.
It's haunting.
It's a disaster.
Really?
Depressing, horrible, bad guy. Springsteen, bad, bad guy.
Really?
So corrupt. All he talks about is his ticket sales. Hey, look at me. I sold out the Meadowlands. Big deal. I sold out the country, David. Hey, listen, are you ready to hear my version of the love theme from Philadelphia? So much better.
Okay, I guess. Yes, please go ahead, Donald Trump.
Trump. I'm just fine. I am using my tuner. Trump.
Okay.
Trump.
Me, no. Only me.
Tramp. ain't no angel gonna greet me. It's just you and I, my friend. My clothes don't fit me no more because I have a new trainer and I don't know what it is. I got a new trainer. I got to get a new tailor because I've been working out and I look great. But I look pretty good considering I was falsely accused of having AIDS on the streets of Philadelphia. Horribly corrupt city, by the way. I was winning by 700,000 votes, and there were irregularities. Rudy explained it beautifully. As the Democrats made hair dye come out of his head. Anyway, it's a real shithole, Philadelphia. Now here's a great thing.
Well, hang on. I have to say.
That's just the song, David. That's just the song. That's just the song, David.
I have goosebumps from that. That's haunting.
Those are genuine goosebumps, not the kind you get from having syphilis.
cage.
Okay, now here's a great scene from our.
Wait, we're going to see a scene now.
It's time. I think the people would like to see a scene. Would you like that?
Would you like that?
Would you like that to see? Here's a great scene from our Netflix remake of Philadelphia.
Okay, this is. Can we roll the clip from the Bigley Productions production of Philadelphia for Netflix?
Hello, Tonel. For those of you who do not know me, I am workplace discrimination lawyer who specializes in victimizing successful companies with bullshit discrimination lawsuits that clog up the courts with all of their bullshits. How may I help you, sir?
Well said. Very well said. Yes, barrister, I know. I couldn't have put it better. Trial lawyers are the worst. Shady characters. I never settle. I don't. But this is one of the few discrimination cases that's legitimate. I want you to sue my law firm. They fired me because they say I have AIDS, but I don't. I couldn't possibly have AIDS. How could I have AIDS if AIDS doesn't exist? Total hoax. Total hoax. Hoax. They say I have the Chinese AIDS. Perfectly healthy. I'm perfect. Look at me. It's all a scam. There's no such thing as AIDS. It's all going to go away. You watch. You watch. Come November. Just like the flu. You shouldn't have fired me, this law firm. I'm perfectly healthy. Everybody's wearing condoms now. Ridiculous. Nonsense.
Absurd. Get the fuck out of here with your nuisance lawsuits and AIDS. I really don't care, do you? I've had it up to here with all these AIDS bullshits. And these Carposis or Kalashnikov Sarsonas.
Again, well said, perfectly articulated. You're very right. You're right, Your Majesty. I'm sorry. What was I thinking asking you to file a frivolous workplace discrimination lawsuit? I'm a dishonest sleazebag, and the people who fired me are just an average Joe, six-pack corporation, trying to live their average Joe lives, going home to their average-looking wives, who are fives in good lighting. They're fives in good lighting. They're an L.A. three. Heidi Cruz is all of them. That patriotic, America-loving corporation had every right to fire me. Thank God. Thank God I live in a country where I have the personal freedom to go look for another job. Pretty good. Pretty good, right, David? Pretty good.
I'll admit it. I was skeptical at first. That is actually more uplifting than the original Philadelphia.
So much more uplifting.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now, this next film is very necessary. It's a very necessary remake of Saving Private Ryan.
Oh.
Okay. Again, another movie that had so much potential, but you know, Steven Spielberg made the mistake of casting that child rapist, bloody baby blood connoisseur Tom Hanks. Nobody knows this.
I don't know if that's
Let me show you the scene that we filmed, Melania and I. May we?
By all means.
May we?
Yes, please.
Okay. So we're storming the beaches, and I play the American leader of a cowardly battalion of men storming the beaches of Normandy, who inherited a lot of problems from the corrupt leadership of the squadron leader who came before him. Wasn't even an American. A lot of people have said.
Okay, let's play the clip. I think he was an American.
Check his papers.
He was a hero.
All right, can we play the clip?
Play the clip. Here we have it. Play the
That's the sound of film rolling, David. Listen, men, there's a lot of good and decent people on both sides of this gorgeous beachfront property. America needs to do the right thing right now and mind its own business. Let Germany and France sort this out. Besides, why are we helping the frogs when all of our manpower should be on the Western Front, coming to the aid of our good friends, Russia, to take back all of Europe? Uncle Joe Stalin, Uncle Joe, great guy. Great guy, very energetic. Very energetic. Loves wheat. Unlike Sleepy Joe.
Unlike who?
Unlike Sleepy Joe.
Oh.
Sleepy Joe. And Kamalama Melakalekimaka is a way of saying I'm a liar. And Dr. Jill Biden. Dr. Jill, the doctor, we'll see you now. The doctor, soldiers, line up to see the doctor. She's going to cure whatever.
I've had it up to here with all of these shootings and killings. Give me a fucking break already. I really don't care, do you?
Thank you.
Yeah. The Greatest Generation. What a great movie. Difficult subject that you're tackling.
May we show you one more?
Sure.
Okay. Tonel. Now I show you my teeth.
Melania.
No.
We already talked about this. Okay. First with it. One more clip.
We only have time for one more clip.
Then spreading the disease. Then...
the conga line.
Conga line. Thank you. Okay.
I have to do it, right?
I didn't say that. That's you saying that. There's no have to. Can we move on? Can we move on to the clip?
I understand you.
Not yet.
Is Vanilla Ice there?
Vanilla Ice has been actually, he's right next to me, and wow. He has really been enjoying these clips.
Oh, wow. He's
like, Mr. President, I can't dance until I've seen these clips.
So exciting. God.
And I said, you could never dance. You get it? Because people said he was a horror show.
Yeah. Yeah. But good peeps. Good peeps. So you have you have another movie that you're filming.
I have another movie. Thank you, David. Here I am with Melania in a remake of The Bodyguard.
Oh.
Okay. This time we got it right. We fixed it.
Okay. I didn't know it needed to be repaired, but can we play
it? Oh, yeah. Boy.
I guess. Okay.
You see the picture?
Yeah, let's play a clip of Melania and Donald Trump in a remake for Netflix of The Bodyguard.
Roll the clip. Who'd you guard before me? Oh, no, so you're my bodyguard?
These are outtakes. I love seeing the outtakes when you guys flub lines. Thank you.
Believe me, Vanilla Ice is cracking up next to me here.
Yeah. Those.
So you're my bodyguard?
Yes, it is I. For those of you who do not know me, it is I, your bodyguard.
Who'd you guard before me?
Rosie O'Donnell?
Really, really? That's a lot of body to guard. Which section of her were you in charge of?
That is top secret emission. Besides, I am not at liberty to say.
That must have been tough, though, stopping all those poachers from trying to steal all her ivory. You see, because Rosie O'Donnell's an elephant who looked like a pig. A pig, David. Sorry, I mean bodyguard. An elephant who looked like a pig.
Wow.
Was that terrific?
Yeah. And, you know,
And the song is even better, David.
Yeah. The song. The Dolly Parton song.
Well, I rewrote it. I wrote my own song for the remake.
Really?
You As wrote- you know, David, I've mentioned this before. My uncle, he was a talented, super genius songwriter.
What was his name?
My uncle, Hoagie Trump. He lived in Long Island.
Really?
You must know his work. He had that classic hit called The Blacks.
Yes, 1964.
May I sing it for you?
Here the Blacks from 1964. Yeah.
Get off my lawn. I'm warning you. That's just a taste.
That's a great song. It really is. Well, Mr. President, we're all out of time. Yeah. Why don't you
Let's get to this song?
Yeah. Why don't you take us out with this verse from the song you wrote for your remake of The Bodyguard?
I can't. Hoagie's work. This is I'm pretty proud of this.
Okay.
Remake of The Bodyguard. I clearly should stay, but the deep state's in my way. So I'll go, but I know you'll miss me every step of the way. Not yet. Jesus Christ.
In the middle of you.
Will always love me. You will always love me. Me. Your darling me. That it goes on and on.
I didn't know you could hit those notes. You go up an entire octave.
I have a knack.
Thank you. You have a knack. Thank you, Mr. President, and your lovely wife, Melania.
Heil Hitler.
What a cute. What a cute
couple.
Now I
show you my teeth.
No, thank you.
Conga line.
What a cute couple. They're an inspiration to us all. You know, they're like all of us right now. They're facing adversity, but somehow they power through it. And I thank them for taking time to come on the show.